Huron Fal served as a venerable dreadnought of the Death Guard Legion 2nd Company during the Great Crusade. Records of Huron's interment within his dreadnought sarcophagus have been lost to time, yet fragments of his deeds remain. During the Battle of Iota Harologi, Fal, alongside the battle captain of the 7th Company, Nathaniel Garrow, and Silent Sisterhood, would battle the Jorgal Xenos. Felling the cybernetic warriors, the Death Guard would purge the hatcheries of the colony void ship before the Jorgal's brood could spread across the system. Revered by his battle brothers within the 14th, despite his stalwart service to his legion, Fal would be marked as untrustworthy during Mortarion's gambit to betray the Emperor. Deployed upon the surface of Istvan III during the War Master's campaign to quell the rebellion of the once compliant world, Huron Fal would fight alongside his stalwart friend, Captain Ulis Temeter, as they enacted the Imperium's judgment upon the populace. For their unerring loyalty to the Emperor, the Death Guard loyalists would be betrayed by their Primarch and kin as the War Master's fleet bombarded the planet. As the Istvanian rebellion withered, Life-Eater virus bombs would descend upon the Loyalist forces and consume every soul subsumed by its plumes of noxious gas. Attempting to shelter themselves within bunkers upon Istvan III's surface, Huron would shepherd as many survivors of the 14th as possible to safety. Protected from the virus due to his dreadnought chassis, Huron would refuse to join the safety of the bunker whilst his battle brothers remained on the surface. Temeter would order the bunkers to be sealed as the bombs unleash their payloads and become infected with the virus's decaying embrace. Gathering the dying captain within his arms, Huron Fal would reveal his own armor's systems to be breached and accept his fate to die alongside his friend. His duty as a veteran to protect his battle brothers achieved to the best of his ability, Huron would state,
"We'll go together then, shall we?"
Huron Fal asked, embracing Temeter's body to him, moving swiftly away from the bunker. It took every last effort from Temeter to nod. Blinded now, he could feel the tissues of his eyes burning and shriveling in his head, the soft meat of his lips and tongue dissolving.
This death is ours. We choose it. We deny you your victory.
As his dreadnought chassis exploded, Huron would end the suffering of his brother's rapidly decaying body. Defiant until the end, Huron would choose death by his own hand rather than the traitors. His service to his battle brothers and the Emperor, unwavering, even in the face of death.